Hi guys, my name is Jaykumar Nair and by profession I'm a Sabri dance choreographer. This is my first video where I'm going to share something incredible which can change the way you think. This is my last few years of experience spending time with different mindset people. Okay, mindset of successful people and unsuccessful people. I'm going to share my learning I got from the successful people by spending time with them, by reading success stories by the most phenomenal authors and their journey to success. Why do they think different and what makes them so different? So I'm sure many of my fans must be also thinking right now, ki why am I not dancing and I'm not an author, not a motivational speaker? Then why am I sharing this crazy millionaire's success stories? Well, for the next few minutes, I want you to forget who I am and focus to what I am going to share. Because watching me performing may not change your life, but this video can change many things in your life. So why is it important to think like a millionaire? So are you ready, guys? Well, so there's this book called Rich Dad Poor Dad by the very well-known American businessman and author Robert Kiyosaki. Okay, he shared his own story in that book. Okay, the book is called Rich Dad Poor Dad. So while his dad was the most educated man, but at the age of 60, he was zero with bank balance. But his best friend dad was completely uneducated, but at the age of 60 he was a multi-millionaire. So whose footsteps should he follow? Of course he followed his best friend's dad footstep, and that's how he became a millionaire today. Okay, so basically rich people have a different way of thinking as compared to poor, as in ordinary and middle class people. Rich people think about money, wealth, themselves, and how can they be unique and different. Here I will share you most important steps. Why is it important to think like a millionaire and examine wealthy, rich, middle class and ordinary people's mindset? By the way, many of you may not agree or may not accept to me because of your past knowledge you carry. And some those who will accept this learning will really change the way you think and live far more better. So I request you to empty your past learnings and fill in with new knowledge. Keep in mind, beliefs are not true or false and right or wrong, but they are merely past opinions which can be modified on your command. In reality, you can select to think in ways that will support you instead of thinking in ways that lead to pain. So ordinary people are poor because of ordinary society mentality. They focus on problems, so they keep getting more and more problems. Wherever they go, they always have one point negative to talk about. What went wrong today and yesterday? They love weekends and hate Monday morning. Job simply sucks, but accepted. This is the life for next 40 years. They complain about everything around. Their thinking is, life happens to me. If you wish to make wealth, it is important that you believe you will make it in this life yourself, and that you will create every single second of your life. If you do not accept this as reality, then you must admit you have little control over your life and that financial success has nothing to do with you. This is not a rich mental attitude. So whatever is going on in their lives, ordinary people prefer to play the character of victim. Certainly, any victim's biggest thought action is poor me, why me? In keeping with the law of intention, that is exactly what they acquire. Poor as in money, why me as in victim. So you can be either a victim or you can be rich. It's time to recall your mind power and admit the fact that you create every single second of your life. You create your wealth, you create your poverty, and you are the decision maker of your own life and success. So ordinary people take part in the race of defense rather than offense. This is actually their main problem. Let's suppose if you are trained to run strictly on defense, what are the chances for you to win the race? That is what majority people do. They play safe. Okay, that is how literally most people participate in the race. Their main objective is to survive. Okay, and think about security, not wealth and abundance. So it's the time for you to decide what is your objective. Rich people, major concern is to become wealthy, earn money and time for themselves and for their family. And ordinary people, a major concern is to have enough to make the living. Few extra bucks for them would be great. Wow, that's amazing for them to go ahead. Again, rethink the power of intention. When your objective is to have enough to make your living, that is precisely how much you'll get. Not even a coin more. So you get what you really plan to get. If you wish to create wealth and your objective has to be rich, then you better think like a person who's rich today. Okay, ordinary people are satisfied with what they have and not interested in becoming rich. So imagine an ordinary man coming to you and says, within the next 12 months, I'm planning to buy a German car. The first question your friend will ask you, how will you make it happen? Are you crazy? Are you stupid? Do you know the expense? Do you know how much you will have to spend on any damages if it takes place? So these are the things what ordinary people will say. Because to become rich, you have to experience the process of struggling and hardship. And ordinary people will never accept hardship. Okay, and if they do, they limit themselves. For which most of them can't and maybe won't even ever give a try if they want to. So we actually have a file on wealth in our minds. This file comprises of our personal beliefs that includes why being wealthy would be good for us. So few of them will think having more wealth will make life a lot more enjoyable. Where others think like, oh my God, I have to work even harder, just like a donkey. So how the heck is that comfy? Some will say, I'll be able to move around the world. Then again, the others react like, nah, I will travel one day, someday. Such confused messages are one of the biggest reason that most people cannot manage to become rich. Actually, the biggest reason why most people don't get what they want is they do not know what they exactly want. So rich people have clarity. They want money. They are powerful believer, have big dreams. They are fully devoted to creating wealth. They are ready to do whatever it takes to create wealth and asset. Rich people get it because they do not spread confused messages in the universe. That's called secret, the law of attraction. If you haven't read the book, Law of Attraction, okay, please go out and look out and do read. Okay, I will also recommend you to go and purchase below in the description so you can have a look. So getting rich is not a one night stand. Okay guys, understand. Do not take me wrong here. It takes solid determination, skill, effort and passion. You have to truly commit to it, both consciously and subconsciously. You have to determine you can really do it and that you really deserve it. If you're not fully devoted to creating wealth, chances are you will not. So rich people think big and ordinary people think small. Believe me guys, everything will change the day you will begin to think big. You want to do big or small, it's totally up to you. Remember, it's not about you, it's about living your objective. It's about living true to your objectives. It's about attending to others. Alibaba's founder, if you do not know who he is, okay, please go around and watch his videos. His name is Jack Ma. He says you build people and people build your business. So you all alone cannot achieve success. In your journey, make sure you take people along with you and make them successful too. So most of us are so caught up in our egos that everything turns around. Me and more me. I repeat, it's not about you. It's about adding values to other people's lives. Again, it's totally up to you. The first way leads to being ruined and full of misery, while the other leads to wealth, meaning and success. So be wise while making your selections. Rich people are bigger than their problems. Ordinary people are smaller than their problems. To get rich, you need a purpose, a strong reason. Why do you want to be rich and wealthy? Your journey will be full of difficulties, ups and downs. You will lose many things on your way. You will cry. You will be in pain. But the day when you make it, everything around you will change. You will be a winner. The point here is that success is messy. And for the same reason, most people don't take it. In other words, they don't want problems, don't want to take risk and the pain in their lives. This is one of the greatest difference between rich people and ordinary people. Rich and successful people are larger than their problems, while ordinary people and unsuccessful people are smaller than their problems. Ordinary people will do almost anything to avoid problems. They are afraid of accepting challenges. The irony is that in their pursuit to ensure that they don't have problems, they have the biggest problem of all. They are unhappy and full of misery. The secret to success is not to try to keep away from problems. Okay, problems are to be solved. When they arise, you should be bigger than any problem. Whether you are rich or poor, doing big or small, problems do not get away. If you are taking a breath, you will always face problems in your life. What's essential to recognize here is that the size of the problem is never the main issue. What really matters is the size of you. Okay, bear in mind, your wealth can only grow to the extent that you want. My scheme is to grow yourself to an extent where you can conquer any problem that gets in your way of achieving your objectives and keeping it once you have it. So do not complain about problems because millionaires are financially warriors. So do not complain about problems because millionaires are financial warriors. And a warrior faces a challenge. He always says, just bring it on. I will overcome all the challenges. So rich people give attention to opportunities and work smart, not hard. Ordinary people give attention to problems. Rich people observe potential's growth and focus on the reward. Ordinary people observe potential loss and focus on the risk. We are not discussing positive thinking here, okay? Instead, we are discussing our usual way of observing the world. Ordinary people come from panic. Their mind are continuously reading for what is going wrong in any situations. The most crucial element of their attitude is, what if I don't make it? What if it doesn't work? Okay, more honestly, it won't work. Rich people, on the other hand, take liability for creating their life and have the mentality, it will work because I will make it happen and I will make it work. So in the monetary world, it's evidenced that the risk is directly proportional to reward. The higher the reward, the greater the chances of risk. Okay, rich people are always willing to take that risk. They are confident in their ability and creativity and look ahead to succeed. On the other hand, poor people always fail to imagine. Hence, they imagine to fail. You have to think outside the box. Buy some time or start something in order to create wealth. You have to focus on opportunities for success all around instead of focusing on risk and problems. Here is a simple solution to this problem, which I guarantee will change your life. For the coming week, I advise you not to sound off in any way. Neither complain about anything using your mouth, nor think unhappy in your mind. You will be surprised with the result and how successful you will feel, okay, about your life and what you'll become in the next few weeks. I promise. Give it a try. And I'm sure there is nothing new if you have heard these life lessons before. But what I've understood is that we think we know everything. I don't need this knowledge, gyan. Okay. And so our own ego do not allow to implement them in our life. Your only key to success is the way you think. You do not have to be a millionaire to think big. But thinking big today will push you to be a millionaire tomorrow. It is important to think like a millionaire. Because you can be a millionaire, buddy. Okay. Guys, here I end my first video. If you have any questions, then send in your comments below and I will answer you soon. In my next video, I will give you more clarity how an ordinary person can become an entrepreneur and achieve financial freedom. Do not miss it. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel if you liked my video as an appreciation. So whatever I am today and known as, it is all because of you. It's network. Guys, until people do not like you, love you, okay, and appreciate you, you will never be successful. And do the same for others. So this is in a small way to make a change in your lives. I hope you liked it. I'm giving away free ebook. You can find the download link below in the description. Thank you very much, guys. Love you all and signing off.